spending 4 hours in a box together every day can make you say crazy things.
I love the smell of mash.
Jeff and Jeremy in the morning.
I saw this yesterday and I thought, oh my gosh, I have to try this. Oreo and Ritz crackers have gotten together and they're making a sandwich. A cookie sandwich? A cookie cracker sandwich?
Let me guess the composition of this good idea, really, to be honest with you, because I like both. And they're both made by the same company, right? Why? How come it took them so long to get these two together?
I know, right? This is ridiculous. This should have happened a long time
ago. Or does Nabisco not make Oreo? Nabisco makes Ritz. I know that. Who makes Oreo? Mondelez?
I don't know. I thought they were both Nabisco. No? They have to be, right? I mean, how do you find this partnership?
I don't know. I think Oreo used to be Nabisco.
Okay.
Is Oreo owned
Oreos go back to 1912. Ritz was launched in 1934. Mondelez International, the corporate umbrella that holds both brands, have been together since 2012. So they've had both brands since 2012. Mondelez. Is that, you said Mondelez? It's a Hispanic name?
I think it's French, to be honest.
Oh, is it?
Mondelez.
Mondelez. Okay.
Ritz is also owned by Mondelez, so it's Nabisco, but Nabisco was siphoned off to Mondelez. Okay, good to know. Okay, so I think it's one part cookie, one part cream, one part Ritz. That would be the best marriage of the two, I think. Okay. But I don't know.
They decided to take it a step further and put some peanut butter in there with the Ritz. Oh, the Ritz peanut butter cracker and the Oreo cookie together. One half is the Oreo side, which is, the creamy white filling and then the cookie. And then on the other side, it's the salty but sweet peanut butter with the Ritz cracker. Oh, it sounds good. I love peanut butter, though. So you're just taking the peanut butter, you're making it a little bit creamier, and would you dunk this in milk? I think I'd have to try that. I don't know about you, but I have to dip an Oreo in milk. I can eat it plain, but man, I would much rather it be soaked in milk. And I'm talking about soaked to the point where it's like a full sponge. As soon as it goes in your mouth, all that milk just comes through the walls.
DL was telling us once that he put canned cheese, easy cheese on an Oreo, and it was very tasty. Did you ever try that? You said you were going to try that when you were high once.
I totally forgot. I don't get high enough, I guess. And when I do, I forget. I totally forget. That's
because
I got a project for this 3-day weekend coming up.
Because the Oreo with the peanut butter, I don't like. But the the Ritz with the peanut butter, I don't like. But the Ritz cheese sandwiches, those the little bits ones, the Ritz bits with the cheese, those are good.
Or making your own with canned cheese. I mean, it's,
you could take the Oreo minis and the Ritz cheese minis and mix them together.
Oh yeah,
just mix them together. They come in separate little canisters. Just mix them together into one bigger canister, or take half out of one and shake them up.
Who wouldn't just put some bacon cheddar out of a can on an Oreo cookie just to see what would happen?
Why bacon? Why can't you just go with regular?
Oh, it's extra salty.
It's gotta be. It's always gotta be next. It's gotta be.
You gotta go one more. Gotta go one more.
The bacon cheese in a can tastes nothing like bacon to me. It just tastes like
it's my favorite flavor.
There's just it tastes like they added salt to a fake cheese.
Oh my god!
Which already has a ton of salt in it.
Ritz,
so why do you need to do that?
Oreo cookies together. And you know, this might even be fine just the way it is. You know, you could just take a Ritz cracker and an Oreo and put some cheese on the Ritz cracker and then smash that Oreo in there. Or you could take one of these Oreo Ritz peanut butter, whatever the hell they're calling them, the mashups, and then you sandwich that with two Ritz on the outside.
I just think peanut butter has cheese. Has had a lot. Not that I don't like peanut butter. I like peanut butter, but I like it like on a piece of toast, thin.
Wow.
I feel like peanut butter has gotten a little too much attention over recent years. You got peanut butter beer. People are putting it on burgers. Too much attention with the peanut butter. Let's go back to the imitation cheese. Okay, come on. Let's give it its due. I want to try that. I want to try that Oreo cookie. Maybe I'm going to try that Oreo cookie. It just seems so over the top to put easy cheese on an Oreo cookie. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Gross, gluttony.
Have you been to Carl's Jr. and seen what they're doing over there with the burgers? I mean, they cut back because I think they were killing people. But, you know, hot dogs, bacon, ham, brisket, sausage.
I miss that. I miss that about CJ's. I really do.
Oh, my God.
I love that.
It was too much. Like, when you can't even taste the meat. Like, how do you taste anything in there?
They did a pastrami burger. They did a hot dog burger that was a hot dog on top of a burger. They did pastrami on top of a burger. They're not doing that anymore, and I wish they would bring it back.
See,
I really do.
Because it's like you put all these meats in there, and you can't taste the burger. I want to taste the burger. That's important to me. Now, putting an egg on a burger or peanut butter on a burger or cheese on a burger, I mean, that's different.
Since we're talking about meat, we got to talk about Kim Kardashian. She has been given... a job. She has a job.
Okay. Oh, does she? Okay.
Yes. And it's with a meat count. It has to do with meat, but not really meat. We'll get to that coming up.
Spending 4 hours in a box together every day can make you say crazy things. Don't go crazy. Jeff and Jeremy in the morning.
So Kim Kardashian is the chief taste consultant for Beyond Meat. I guess she apparently is she's a non-strict vegetarian.
Okay.
What does that mean?
That means that she eats meat sometimes, I'm guessing. I don't know. Non-strict vegetarian? Like
my sister-in-law, who is the virtue signaler of all virtue signalers, not my wife's sister, my step sister-in-law, so it's like my stepbrother's wife.
Oh, in Seattle?
Yeah, she is the biggest virtue signaler of all time, you know. I mean, I think the minute her kids got hair, she dyed the kids' hair pink just to prove a point or something. She is a vegetarian. At least she says she is. You ever meet vegetarians and you're like, how? Like on the surface, you meet them and you're like, nah, you can't be because then how?
Because they're fat?
Yes.
Well, you know, there's a lot of carbs and pastas and things that come from animals. You know,
she said, oh, I'm vegetarian, but sometimes I cheat. I like bacon. And I'm like, that's not a vegetarian.
Yeah, you're not a vegetarian. You're just somebody who doesn't eat a lot of meat.
Is that what a non-strict vegetarian is?
I believe so, yeah.
I tell everybody I'm a vegetarian, but then when I go home and I'm by myself in the kitchen, I lock myself in the pantry with a big plate of hot dogs.
And chocolate-covered bacon.
So this is just straight influencer stuff, right? There's a video of her online, and she is the chief taste correspondent for Beyond Meat.
Beyond Meat, that I've stepped in to help with my greatest asset, my taste. This plant-based meat is not only amazingly delicious, but it's also better for you.
Did she say butter for you? I swear to God, she said butter for you because she's thinking about butter.
She said better for you. But isn't it obvious that this is like a read?
Oh, yeah. I mean, of course.
Like, is she really passionate about Beyond Meat?
Yeah, she has like
non-strict vegetarian.
I don't know. She has like 20 million followers on social media, maybe more, probably more. So yeah. That's all they care about. They just want her talking
Beyond
to people.
Meat, yeah. But
I understand that. I totally understand
stepped
that.
Stepped in to help with my greatest asset.
My taste.
This plant-based meat is not only amazingly delicious, but it's also better for you and better for the planet.
Butter, see, butter.
It's a simple change that makes a really big difference.
So good.
Why is it butter for the planet?
And now that I'm Beyond Meat...
Well, she's just shoving the chicken strips in her face, too.
There's never a better time to go beyond.
So, I guess non-strict vegetarian means you could eat a lot of fake meat. Like just
yeah, there's a couple of things. Okay, the vegetarian that are fat, yes. We're going to pick on fat people. I could lose some.
Well, I just don't understand it. When somebody says I'm a vegetarian, and I'm looking at them, and they're they're not in great shape. I'm like, how? I want to know how that is. It just Twinkies? Do you just eat Twinkies?
I was watching this radio guy talk about the new, the Mexican pizza coming back to Taco Bell. And he's like, and it's back. And he's doing his like video podcast. So he's like, got a camera on
gross,
him.
Gross,
and he's
gross.
Sitting there and he's like, yeah, mother. And he's dropping F bombs because he's not on the radio right now. He's doing his own podcast. And here it comes. And he starts eating this thing. And oh my God, the guy had four chins. And he's just like, I'm just like, this is disgusting. Who would watch that? It looked like Jabba the Hutt. It was just disturbing. Ugh, don't eat on camera.
Do you watch people eat?
No, I can't. It bothers me.
Like if you go to dinner with people and you're eating your dinner, do you watch how other people eat?
No. Do you?
Okay, I don't. No, I don't.
Yeah, you do.
I don't.
You're a weirdo.
I don't.
That's a weird thing to ask. And it's
no,
really
you
weird.
Were very you were very descript in watching the DJ eat the Mexican pizza.
Well, because I wanted to see what he was going to do, and then he started eating it. I'm like, oh God, this is disgusting. And it was just, it was the angle too, because you know nobody knows how to do the angle on their phone when they do a FaceTime type deal. So it's shooting up into his three chins,
nice.
And up his mouth, and it's just like, and it's getting all over his face and. Jesus, it's very unpleasant. So Kim Kardashian is pushing fake meat. Great.
Continues to rake in the money. Just continues.
I hope this really becomes a trend so real meat is cheaper. You know what I mean? Like if everybody just starts eating fake meat.
Eat the fake meat.
Then all this excess of, you know, of real meat.
The problem is the transportation costs to get the meat is what's driving up the cost of the meat right now. I don't think there's too much of a shortage.
They got to transport fake meat too, don't they? I mean...
The other day, Jeremy, this is you'll get a kick out of this. You want a hack? You want an inflation hack?
Yeah.
You know what? I know we're running short on time because we've talked about Kim Kardashian's quote unquote vegetarianism.
Okay.
Not non-strict vegetarianism because in 2 years I plan on being a shill for fake meat. this is a great inflation hack, and I got to tell you about it. I don't know if it still works. I think it does, especially if you hit it at the right time. It has to do with chicken. I'll tell you about it coming up.
Careful. You don't want to learn from this. Jeff and Jeremy in the morning on 93.3 KZOZ.
So this is the chicken inflation hack. Okay. I was wandering around my local grocery store looking for chicken. And this was, I want to say this was about... this is probably March. So right when inflation started, you know, taking off. And chicken prices went through the roof. And they said, oh, it's because, you know, there's a bird flu or whatever. Whatever the excuses are to raise prices, right? And I'm walking around, I'm looking at frozen chicken. And I'm like, I'm not paying this much for frozen chicken. This is ridiculous. I'm not going to do this. I was just going to make chicken for a chicken enchilada casserole that I make.
Okay.
I walk over to the deli. I see the rotisserie chicken sitting there.
Okay, yeah.
Which, by the way, I forgot to check the price the other day when I was at Costco. Because I think I might just start doing this when it comes to chicken. They could cook it for you, right?
Ready to go.
You don't have to do anything.
I got one 2 weeks ago.
I hate cooking chicken. I hate cooking chicken because it's gross, it's nasty, it's dirty, it's foul. There's a reason why it's called foul. Okay, it's a dirty meat. You
plus, the
clean
Costco
it right.
chicken is the best rotisserie chicken.
Right. It is the best chicken. Now, I did not get this at Costco. I was at my local grocery store, so I got their rotisserie chicken. It was fine. It was perfectly
still,
fine.
Rotisserie is the best chicken. Way to cook a chicken, I think.
It was $6.99 at the time. This was like in March, so it might be more now. But it was $6.99 for, I guess, how much is on a rotisserie chicken?
It's like a full chicken, though, yeah.
24 ounces of chicken?
Yeah, I know.
16? I mean, it's a big
it's
chicken.
It's four meals at my house, at least.
Okay. Yeah, me too, because we made a huge
we'll eat half of it one night, and then the next day we'll put it in a salad, or we've made enchiladas with it.
And yeah, we had leftovers, you know, made a little chicken salad out of the leftovers. It was $6.99. If I would have bought the same amount of chicken in the frozen section, it was going to be $18.99.
Yeah, true. This is a good chicken hack. Because, and we accidentally did it, because I bought the chicken to, because I wanted some, because you walk by and you smell them. And I was at Costco, and I got home, and I ate a leg, and while I was preparing tri-tip. And then the next day we had this chicken. I'm like, what are we going to do with it? And so I put it in the crock pot with some broth and I put it on high and got it all steamed up, shredded all the meat off of it. And we rolled up chicken enchiladas that night.
Yeah. I'm telling you.
But I didn't realize that it was so much cheaper to go that route than to buy, you know, if you buy a full chicken.
Whoa. How much did it cost you when you bought it?
I want to say it was $6. It wasn't very much.
Was it $6?
I don't know. It might have gone up. I didn't really look at the receipt.
So you can buy an article online. This was dated a year ago or a little less than a year ago. Article online that said Costco's rotisserie chicken will always be $4.99.
Yeah, that's probably what it was.
Like their hot dogs are always going to be $1.50
with a soda
when you buy them outside with a soda.
Why don't they make that into a corn dog? That would be the best corn dog ever. Number one, it's massive. I'm going to put a suggestion in the Costco box. I love the hot dog, but can you imagine if that Costco dog was a corn dog?
Jeremy's the only person. I just picture them going through the suggestions like once a month, and they like six entries from you and one from another guy.
Yeah,
and then that's it.
There's that Jeremy from AG again. It's Dumbass of the Day, and it's brought to you by California Diesel and RV. They want to remind you that there are good decisions and questionable ones. And when it comes to diesel and RV repairs, they want you to rely on faces you know and service from people you can trust. That's California Diesel and RV. If it runs on diesel, they're your people. 1189 Pike Lane in Oceano.
Hey, let's do Dumbass of the Day.
Wah, 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 wah.
I'm from a tiny little town, a little backwoods town called Saxbahal, North Carolina. Every July 4th around the South, rednecks blow themselves up left and right. See, the terrorists have got it wrong. Stop trying to build an underwear bomb and just open up a roadside fireworks stand on the way to the beach. We'll do the work for you. Just stand outside a Carolina Panthers football game handing out old Milwaukees and M80s. We'll be blowing up left and right. But they don't teach that in the fancy terrorism school. That's not jihad, that's yeehaw!
Dumbass of the Day. 93.3 KZOZ.
We're heading off to the south, one of your favorite places, Florida. We're a landscaper who was recently released from jail. It was a felony. He was out on parole. He's 29 years old. Started his own landscaping business. You know, go around, mow some grass. He liked to be paid every week, though. And this week he asked the gentleman in one of the homes that he was mowing if he could be paid on Thursday. The gentleman said, no, I'm going to be out of town. I'll have to pay you on Friday. Now, Peter Dusick is his name. Very upset about this. He needed his money. Probably for drugs, I'm guessing, but I don't know. Because when he went and knocked on the door on Thursday, the guy's wife answered the door, and she said, no, he's not home, and I don't have the checkbook, and he's going to have to work it out with you tomorrow. He'll be back tomorrow. He got all upset, peeled off.
I need my money today. I need my money today. I got to get drugs.
Yeah. No. Anyways, he wasn't gone long. He came back a half hour later, put an explosive device in their mailbox, and blew it to shreds.
Who just has explosive devices? These are the people I'm talking about.
I know.
These are the people that...
mentally unstable.
Yeah.
Yeah, lock who just has something that'll blow up a mailbox in your car?
Oh, you don't have a payment for me? Okay, hold on a second. I'll be back in 30 minutes. I'm going to blow up your mailbox.
And if you are a convicted felon like this guy is, you shouldn't have access to that kind of stuff. Not legally, anyways, but see, it doesn't stop people when they break the law.
But the problem with this, Jeremy, is like, you know, like you... police forces are depleted for... obvious reasons. That's why we're having a tough time with law enforcement in this country. And then, you think that's going to take a toll on the probation officers out there as well. Like, yeah. How are they able to do their jobs if there's not enough of them?
No, everybody is taking a hit over what this country's been going through for the last few years. And defunding, law enforcement hasn't helped things at all. But they were able to find this guy, track him down, and get him. Shrapnel from the explosion went 50 feet, damaging other houses, signs, cars, things of that nature. No big deal, buddy. Now you're going to jail, and you're not going to get paid. Should have thought about that first. Congratulations, Peter Dusick. You are Jeff and Jeremy's
Dumbass of the Day. It's Jeff and Jeremy in the Morning on 93.3 KZOZ.
Here we go. It's Name That Classic Rock Tune. It's presented by Perry Ford. We're giving away $500 in cash right now.
Don't forget, they're having the big gas grab part D out there this weekend. They're going to have drawings every 10 minutes. They're going to be giving away $100 gas cards and tickets to the Avila Beach Blues Festival on Saturday morning from 10 to noon. Plus, there'll be food there and all that stuff. So.
Let's get to our final contestants. We got Mike and Tom. They were the two that were drawn out of the hat. Mike, how many games did you win when you played your qualifying round for Name That Classic Rock Tune? Do you remember?
Three.
All right. And Tom?
Two.
Two.
Yes. Okay, you guys are both correct on that one. No points for that. No points for that, but you do remember.
I'm going to remind you how the game works. Jeff is going to give you the year the song came out, then he's going to play it. You ring in with your name by saying your name through the phone. When you know title and artist, you have to know both. As soon as you get three right, you win. First one to three wins $500 in cash, okay?
Yeah.
If I've learned anything, it's that people love hearing their city's names mentioned. Tom, where do you reside? Who will you be representing today?
I will be representing my brethren in a town.
A town? A town known as Atascadero. And Mike.
Got it.
Where will you be representing today?
Royal Grande.
AG.
AG in the house, five cities, my home.
Another A town, but they did, I guess Atascadero beat them to it, so they just had to go with AG.
AG town? Yeah, it wouldn't flow the same, would it?
Right.
All right. Once again, good luck to both you guys. Ring in by saying your name very loud and clear when you know the song. Jeff will give you the year.
This is.
You just have to get three right to win. First one to three wins.
$500.
Yeah,
winner take all. Winner take all. Everybody's been qualifying for this all year long. We're finally getting to it. We were supposed to do this last week, but that's fine.
I don't think we were. I don't think there was a time limit on when we were supposed to do this.
Oh, okay.
It actually makes a lot of sense. We played a week ago today, our last qualifying round, that today we would give it away.
No, that's true. And they
Cal
do
Poly
kick off.
Is on the way to Hawaii.
Yeah. They kick off their series today. Okay. So the first song, guys, 1976. You know the rules. Ring in by saying your name when you think you know what it is. Okay. Now, remember, if you ring in too early, your opponent gets a lot more of the song to figure out. Okay. So don't, when you think you know what it is, ring in.
Got it. Tom.
If a town, Tom. What is it?
Here we go. Thin Lizzy, Jailbreak.
That is absolutely correct. Good job. Tonight there's gonna be a jailbreak somewhere in the town. Tom's got a 1-0 lead over Mike.
Doing it for the North County.
Doing it for the North County.
All right. Where are we going next, Jeff?
1987.
Tom.
Wow. Commanding. What is it, Tom?
REM. Might have been too fast on this one.
Just need the title, Tom.
End of the World as we know it.
That is correct. Wow, we were about ready to buzz you out.
Oh, my gosh. Two back-to-back. Look at that. Tom from A-Town.
1987.
Eighth grade graduation.
Right on. Wait, that makes you, what, graduated in 92?
91.
Okay, all right. Okay.
All right, Mike, are you still there?
Yep.
It's okay, not too Mike. Late for you, Mike, but you have to get this one right.
Yeah, well, no, I know.
you're fighting for
Come
your
on,
life.
Mikey. All
right. Fighting for your life. When was your eighth grade graduation, Mike?
Oh, God. 85? 84?
Okay. We'll go to 1984 then. Here we go. This song's from 1984. I got to give him an eighth grade graduation song, too. You understand, right, Tom?
Yeah, fair is fair.
Okay, here we go. Ring in when you think you know what it is.
Mike.
Mike, go ahead.
Pretenders, Dip in the Road?
That is incorrect. Sorry, Mike. Tom. This is, you could be living on Easy Street with this one. Here we go.
All right, I think I got it.
Go ahead, Tom.
Pretenders, middle of the road.
It is the middle of the road. Congratulations, yeah. Tom.
Come on now. Let's go with Tom Cadero.
There you go, $500. Nice job, wow. Tom. $500.
Mike.
My dog is very excited.
Yes, sir.
Mike, what happened?
Between trying to hear the songs and working, I couldn't do it.
Oh, man, I'm so sorry we called you at work. Good thing, Tom. Fortunate for you, Tom, you don't work, right?
Yeah, you know, some people say that. My wife thinks I don't work.
All right, well, congratulations, Tom. Hold on the line here a second. Mike, nice try, man. There's $500 gone. Thanks to Perry Ford and Name That Classic Rock Tune. We'll be right back.
Subscribe to the Jeff and Jeremy podcast now on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Google, and YouTube. It's your Central Coast commute-friendly podcast.